this first hand, I have aces on the CL. There's three very competent players in the game, but everyone, including me, is probably a bit splashy for some likings. And I start with the open raise for 436. It's my standard raise in this game, so there's not much to read into it. And there's going to be a lot of good scenarios right now where someone is going to 3-bet me, and I can 4-bet them for value in position. Pat-Patman 3-bet me. At this stage, this is a hand before Christmas. He wasn't 3-betting too much. He might turn up his aggression a bit right now, but he definitely understands position and as a live player, and he has a tough one when Hillary folds and is back to me. He can obviously 4-bet. I don't 4-bet him too much, and this session I've not done it once, I know, and I decided to be a bit deceptive and just flat call. Also, I kind of want to have aces in my flatting range here sometimes versus a tough opponent. And the flop is actually kind of mediocre. It's hits quite a bit of his tribute range quite well. This, one thing I forgot to say is he was still tributing value heavy and high card heavy. So I think I could actually dunk here some of the time, but with stacks and with his handwriting ability, it can make life very hard for me, and I want to keep my range open. So I decide to check call and make some big turn decision, and some cards may be moves. This really illustrates the concept of being positioned in below. Even if I bloated a free flop, I will not get too much of my stack in. So get as blank as you can get, and I think with stacks, a lot of players are just gonna keep on putting pressure on in position. I'm looking like a draw, probably not too many sets slow playing this flop because it's so drawy, so you can get in lots of money very good before you lose action versus like top pair with kickers and stuff. And Pat-Patman has been a bit cally versus me, and he bets not full pot but close to it on the turn. If you look a bit closer in stacks, almost sets up for a river show, because if I call, it's gonna be close to 30k in the pot, and with 35 back, it's put me in such an awkward position. It's not like super obvious, but I think the clearly best play versus him with his ranges, that's a lot of top pair with just kickers, and quite a bit of not flush draw with or without a pair, like ace, queen, queen, three with not diamonds, or ace king something with not diamonds. So I decided also with stacks that they might do some hero folds, so it's not a real value bluff in any sense, because I do it for value, but I still think he might do some equity mistakes with, like, yeah, if you have like two pairs, that's worse than kings up. I might do very well a bet fold this turn for a show, so I just pot it in. I will play obviously some sets this way, some top pair with not flush draws, and other hands I want to trap him because it's such a good spot for a check call check raise line versus a 3-better, because I think it's, if he fire flop with stacks, he's gonna fire turn quite a lot, and he gets it in instantly if I remember correctly. And yeah, it looks like a bad beat story, but I think it's kind of interesting with stacks. And if you check, what hands we actually had, I'm 64%. Obviously, it's a very good scenario, but I think a lot of his possibly high card heavy free betting range is made up of hands with a not flush draw that can call the show with or without a pair. We block top set, I forgot to say it, is really important. And I'm quite satisfied how I play this hand, even though I obviously wanted to win it.